welcome to our stay-at-home shopping network episode 3. Today has been a little bit different because we had planned to get a ginormous palette of new stuff, and guess what happened? Tell them what happened, Zeb.
So I called up the place to see if it had arrived as it was scheduled, and it is held up in Denver because apparently they got 9 inches of snow.
I know, I'm like, snowstorm, what situation is that? And when you come on, say hello, and if you love shopping, DIY, junk, all kinds of things, make sure to give us a thumbs up and make sure you hit that subscribe button. Everything that we show you today is going to be available at jamierayvintagehome.com. That is where you're going to go to purchase everything. In fact, all of the listings are up. If anything is misspelled, I'm sorry.
Hopefully everything has a price too. Sometimes that sneaks by when we're hurrying.
The good news is because the palette didn't come, we finished up a ton of projects today and photographed things that were in the shop. And Zeb made a bunch of stuff that was on our heavily requested list for handmade. So we got a little creative.
Yep. So we're going to go ahead and get into this.
You can start from the top.
Yeah.
And work your way down. And Mariah is on here. So Mariah, would you drop that link to the website so that way everybody will know what we have available today?
All right. So you guys may have seen this. This is a thrifted tote. The bottom is metal. And then the sides are wood with the handle. And this is, what's this painted in? I wasn't here when this got painted.
That's painted in a lot of things. It's Old 57 with Farm Fresh and white wax. It was painted by our 8-year-old little boy, Redrick. And I'm going to pull it up right now so that I can get all the deets.
Let's Jamie's got all the pricing and things.
Why can I not find this? Let's see. I'll look by the name.
What did you call it? Tote?
I called it Redrick.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to bring that camera a little closer so when I hold things up, you guys can see the detail really well while she's looking that up.
All right. I'm going to try looking at
it. We have a ton of items, and some of the handmade items that I did today are going to always be in stock. Like, if we run out,
we'll make more. So Redrick's tote is $12.95, and it's listed as Redrick's tote, and it's up on the website. Most of the items that are one of a kind like this, you're going to find in our antique, vintage, and found collection, which is where that is. It's got a cool texture because he painted in like 452 directions.
He had fun. All right, so little tote.
We've got Transcend Furniture from Nova Scotia, and Summer Valentine said she placed her first order today.
All right.
Sweet. All right, so second item up, little baby birds.
These are found, I believe.
These are found, and
we only have two.
They come in a set of two. So if you buy them, you get the both of them.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull this sticker
off the
bottom.
And they are priced at $6.95. They are listed as set of red birds, and we decided to list those because Jean brought them, and she's like, "You need to sell these little birds. Aren't they the cutest? They're cardinals, right?
Because yes.
They're red. Cute little red cardinals.
A couple little cardinals, and just to give you kind of reference. That's a lot of why we do this, because it's fun to see how big things actually are.
In
and
real
it's
life.
Not very big.
And they're
big.
Made of resin, right? That's what I put on the list.
Yeah, they're resin.
Yeah, they're really cute. They're a set of two, and they are $6.95. So, oh, look at Mariah. She's dropping links to situations. All
nice.
Right. Next, let's go to the tarnished silver. So this is the only piece of tarnished silver that is listed by itself. It's the silver shell dish. It's $24.95. It actually has feet on the bottom. Zeb wants to show you that.
Complete with price.
Complete with a price tag.
This helps people find what it is when
it's
time to
ship. When we're shipping, I have things on the bottom. That one's really cute, $24.95. It's silver plated. It's actually got a good weight to it. It's not
yeah,
flimsy.
Well, so this is all fairly thin and pressed, but this back piece, look at the heft on that. It's
yeah,
got some good weight.
Girth to it. And showing the detail on the top, I love that like floral kind of fancy schmanciness. Mother's Day is coming, so if you haven't bought your mom something and she wants something unique and the situation is keeping you away from antique stores, now's the time to hit up the website because, you know, we got the stuff.
All right, I have something over here.
Oh, Wendy's here and Carts and Millie Tarnia's here. All right, so this is an urn, which I think would be really great. It's like, I think it was terracotta before I painted it.
Yep, it's terracotta.
And it would be really great if you planted a plant for your mom in it. Now, it's an urn, the kind you put flowers in, not your grandma, because it doesn't have a lid.
Yeah, flowers, not grandma.
Old 57 and white waxed. That actually has been up on the website since yesterday I put that one up. So let me see if I can find it on here. Old 57 resin urn, it's $14.95.
Look at Mariah. Mariah, she's already on there. It.
She has got those links going. All right. Next, let's show them the rest of the silver.
Okay.
So all of the silver plates Seb's going to show you, they're all priced at $12.95
each.
Even though they're different, and they are organized on the website by the letter that I assign them, and I put it with.
This is letter H.
I put tape on the back so that way whoever ships know which one goes to who. Let me pull these up here. I have an extensive collection of silver because I really like it. So this is H.
Well, we love the tarnish on it. The older and crustier, the better.
Yeah, I would say it's all silver plated. Some of it could be worth more money. I don't have time to look it up. So $12.95 each. And this one is H. And I believe they go from H all the way to A.
Okay.
If they're stacked in the order in which I initially stacked them.
All right, so next.
And each picture, when you go to the website, will show the letter, so that way you know which one you're buying. You just click the drop-down menu.
This one is G. It's got some fun blue tarnish going on it.
I love putting these in chicken feeders, like stacked up, super cute. That's how we have them displayed in the shop.
Can you guys see the detail? It's got some carved detail in there.
Yeah, that one's really fun. That's G. We got a lot to show, so we're going to have to...
Gonna have to get going.
Next one is F. I like this one because it almost has a lace detail on the edge, and it's a little bit more of a dark tarnish than the other ones, so it's kind of fun. And I have known people to get my tarnished silver and polish it up new again. I leave it on there like that because, you know, with age, things get better.
Size reference. So this is the same.
Chest is the size reference.
I'm just showing them by my head so you can see.
I think I put like the average measurement of them on.
So
there,
this
like
one here
11.
Is E. It's a little bit different coloring, but it's the same design as G was.
A little bit different in the tarnish though.
Yeah, tarnish is a little bit different.
Hello, Italy from Greece. I'm so happy your people are recovering. We are happy too. Italy had a rough bout of it. New York has had a rough time. Utah has been faring fairly well in the current situation. All right, so this is D. This one's fun. It does have cutouts. It's hard to tell, but there are some cutouts in D. And this one's round all the way around.
Like you guys get to see yourselves.
And this
here,
one...
the backside shows the cutouts a little better. You can see where they're punched through.
Yeah. So that's D, and this is C. Isn't that pretty? I love a whole table setup with this tarnished silver. A lot of people also will buy them and hang them on a wall or make giant wreaths with tarnished silver. Now we have two of these ones. This is B, and there's two Bs, which
two
I actually
Bs.
Am not sure if I put two in because I only have one of everything else, so I probably need to fix that one. Yeah, we have two Bs.
So these are fairly thin, probably the thinnest so far, but they've got the good patina on them, so they got added to the collection.
Well, and if you're wanting a set, this is the only one that you're going to be able to get a set of. All the silver platters are $12.95 each, and looks like Odelia just showed up. How you feeling, Odelia? Are those boys driving you crazy? Age makes all things better. It does. Except for wrinkles. I'm not a fan of that, but, you know.
All right, so this is A, and I'm not sure what happened here. Maybe someone started to give it some polish?
Yeah, and then it's... W.M. Rogers silver plate.
Yep.
Inspected by number 9, it says.
I'm trying to show them close. What are you doing?
Oh, wait. Okay.
Let go.
All right. Sorry. I didn't know where you were going with that one.
It's not picking up the details super great because of all the tarnish, but there is carving on the bottom.
Can you shove a laundry cart and a hair rack in the same box? Yep. But there's still the shipping the website calculates is the same. And most of the time, it actually costs us a little bit more than what we charge because shipping big stuff is expensive.
Little handmade sign by Jamie.
That's right. And Eliza, she did the stenciling. I painted it. So this is kind of fun. This is our newest set that happens to be on sale at jamierayvintage.com right now.
Set of stencils.
If you want to buy the stencil, you get the stencils to do everything on this for $3.95 at jamierayvintage.com. And that's only on sale for another week. And then it's gonna go up to $7.95 just for the stencil. This particular sign, if you want the sign, is $19.95. And it's hand painted, the frame is waxed, And then we just stenciled in white, and then the little heart is in cowgirl coral, which I thought was super, super cute. So I love that, and I just thought with everything going on, a fun little sign with a bird, and we included the little heart just to let you know that, you know, the little Jamie Ray vintage bird logo. And that one's $19.95 for that. And that one, we will make as many signs as people want to buy.
All right, because you guys asked, we've got a charcuterie board. It's a hard word to say.
Charcuterie. So hold on, let me make sure I get the right one. There's so many of those now that you made. So this one is, let me look at the picture. I named them all.
So it has, okay. On one side, it has a little bit of a dish to it so that you can put your stuff on there and it's not gonna wanna weeble wobble off. And then this side, if you wanted to use it like a cutting board or you needed something flat to display, is just flat.
And this is the charcuterie board. That's the title for this one. It's 25.5 inches by 5.5 inches by 1.5 inches tall.
Because you guys asked for it, it's got the bird logo on it and a hole so you can hang it.
What? You're used to me being like, hey, could you do this?
So this wood is just scrap wood from the farmhouse. It is not old wood.
But
if it's old, we disclaim that in the listing.
But this is the ends to our floor joist. So it did start at the farmhouse.
It did.
So we're paying for more wood for the walls with the ends of the floor joist. So I thought that was a pretty good idea.
So this is, they're pretty tall. I mean, that's my forearm there, which is about 18, 19 inches tall.
Yeah,
so
it's 25.5 inches.
Yeah.
And that's listed under charcuterie board. That's gonna be in the handmade or the kitchen collection at jamierayvintagehome.com. What? The milk glass vases made it all the way to Italy in perfect condition. I'm so excited, Liana. I tried super hard to wrap them, but also not to make the box super big because it's really expensive to ship to Italy. I am so glad that those made it, and fast too. If you guys are wanting to buy anything and you're out of the country, you have to email info@jamierayvintagehome.com because this website is not set up for international shipping, but I will, if you need something shipped internationally, give you a quote and ship to you as long as it's legal to do so, because Liana got her milk glass vase collection. That makes me happy. I'm always a little nervous, especially when it's going all the way to Italy.
Here is another board. This one I would probably classify more as like a cutting board, but it's got these fun handles on the end that are shaped.
Is that the one? Okay, so that is the charcuterie rectangle with two handles.
Yeah.
That one is $39.95 and it measures 23 inches by 9 inches by 1.5 inches. And these are all stained and sealed with food safe products. So you can totally put your food on them. We use Sweet Pickens milk paint in a watered down faux stain and hemp oil, and that makes them food safe.
So, you know, you could use them as a centerpiece on the table because they're big, or you can actually use them for food and cutting and serving things.
Lolly said she got her conveyor belt buckets. That's awesome. We're actually sold out of those, so I'm glad you guys got them when you did. I actually saw that we did have a sale, so I'm going to go over to orders and see what people are ordering.
This also has the bird. So everything that Harrington and I are hand making will come with the little bird on it. I just have to remember to put it on there.
Yeah. Well, I will make sure before it ships it gets it. So Laura bought the tarnished silver plate F. So that's no longer, that one's gone. So if you want some of that tarnished silver, it's starting to sell. Thank you, Laura, for your order. All right, we're moving.
We have more boards. We have some fun designs because, you know, when you guys ask for things, I like to listen and give you what you want.
And lucky for you, the palette didn't come today. So Zeb was like, hey, I'll make stuff.
So this is another cool board.
Carton Millie gave us a super chat. She's all the way in Australia, and she said, thanks for the board inspiration. Thanks, Carton Millie.
Oh, Carton Millie has some cool boards going on, too.
The first board that we showed was $39.95, Laura. And if you guys need to combine orders for the first 24 hours, if you make more than one order, you can email, and I will combine them where possible and refund shipping, or I can add to your order if you email me, just so you know. Because I know it gets a little crazy on these stay-at-home shopping networks. I want to make sure you get all the things you want to get.
Yeah. All right, so this one is big. How big is this one, Jamie? I didn't measure. I was
so
just making stuff.
So this one measures, hold on, I did measure, 31 inches. So it's the biggest charcuterie board that we offer, 31 inches by 9 inches by 1.5 inches. And it has the cutout handles as well.
The handles are what make it awesome.
Gavin, we're not painting today because this is the stay-at-home and network.
Yep.
But we will be painting our chicken coop tomorrow, so you'll have to check out that edited
video. We'll finish the coop and show you how we put the roof on, and it'll be edited, so we won't be dealing with a live stream, so you guys will be able to hear and see us good.
Sugar Spindles, if you cannot, you might not be on the right website. This is JamieRayVintageHome.com. If you go to any of the links that Mariah has put in, it will take you to the correct website. Let me know if you still can't find those. And Mariah's on, so she can maybe help give you a direct link to what you're interested in. So again, this one is the largest of the charcuterie boards, and it's $49.95 for that one. So that completes all the charcuterie boards that Zeb made today.
Well, I do have a fancy one, but it's more of a cutting board.
What?
The one that's almost, it's butcher block thick.
Hold on. I forgot.
So this one here is...
This is
special wood. So the place I get my specialty lumber, they don't let me cull the lumber, which is hand pick it. I just kind of get what they bring up. And look what board they brought me. The rest of the boards mostly look like this. But check out this side on this board.
So this is a poplar cutting board. And this one is big. It's actually 2 inches thick and measures 23 by 10 by 2. So it's butcher block thick. It's the thickest of all of the boards that we offer. And we only have 3 available at this time with this particular coloring on them. And they're $49.95.
I only got 1 board out of 8 that look like this. The rest of them kind of look like this coloring here.
Yeah, but for this
which is still cool. We'll still make some like this, but these ones are special.
Yeah, so those ones are special. We have 3 available. $49.95, and they measure 23 by 10 by 2, so they're the thickest board that we offer.
And that's not burned. The black is just black.
And it's not stained. This is just sealed with hemp oil.
Yep.
Sean McMillan says, fabulous.
Food safe.
All right.
How big is this one?
That one, 23 by 10 by 2.
So it's the same size as the other one that I showed, I think.
But it's the thickest because it's a full 2-inch dimension.
And I didn't dish out the handles. I left them full thickness.
Really? You can cut on them? Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You can. These are our charcuterie boards, and our wooden cutting boards are just like the kind you're going to buy, except for they're handmade. And you can cut on them, you can wipe them. You're not gonna obviously wanna put them in the dishwasher.
We take a lot of special care to make sure we use food safe, bio-certified products on these so that you can use them so they are functional. So, you know, use them and hand them down to your grandchildren or your children.
Yeah, and if you get something stained on them, you can totally like sand that off and fix it with some hemp oil or whatever. They're only gonna get better with time. So next up, we have cutting boards. A few weeks ago, we did the kind with they go up on the sides, and these are the rounded, which actually are the more popular style. Zeb was gonna do the angled, and I said, nope, do some rounded ones. So we have the medium and the large cutting board.
And these are big. They're like 11.5 inches wide. And you could also use these for like serving or whatever, you know, put your spread out. Look at this one. Put your spread out on that.
I thought you were going to say more, so I was quiet, and then it was just like...
No, we had a moment of silence after your big spread comment.
Well, when I'm hungry. So these are the rounded rectangle cutting boards. The biggest one is going to measure 35 inches tall,
Does that include the handle?
Yes, 35 inches top to bottom. And the medium is 25 inches top to bottom. And they are priced at $49.95 and $59.95. And again, they're food safe. So you can put your food on them, you can cut up your grapes on them, you know, when you're slicing grapes.
And they're all going to be a little bit different because they're handmade. The size will generally be the same, but sometimes the shape of the handle will be a little bit different. Sometimes the shoulder, like if we're dealing with a knot or whatever, will dive off a little more. So they're pretty custom when you get these ones that are handmade.
Orders are coming in. Delissa just purchased the... wooden cutting, the charcuterie board with cutout handles.
Oh, nice.
I feel like I can say that because she commented it and I saw her order. Thank you for your order, Delissa. All right, is that all for the let's do the totes.
So we have totes, and I also made a new set of corbels.
Add corbels.
I don't even know what corbels are.
Not on the website yet. So okay. Let's do the totes, and then I'll take a picture of you with the corbels, and I'll put them on the website while we're here. Mariah is the only one that caught my sliced grapes joke. Thanks.
Give me just a sec. I gotta unload it.
So we have 2 totes that Zeb made, and Harrington's going to be making them. Zeb usually makes the prototype, and then Harrington makes the other ones.
And then I teach the apprentice how.
There's always, like a Jedi, there's always a master and apprentice.
you know, he's going to go off to college. I'm going to have to show Odelia how to do all this stuff.
Or you'll have to have the farmhouse finished, so you can do it. All right, so the totes are $29.95 and $49.95. This is the medium-sized tote, and this one is the smaller of the two. It measures 20 by 11 by 5, and they're finished in a weathered gray finish. We use the Olden Gray by DIY and white wax, so you get a really great age on them. And they're made with, how thick is the plywood?
So this is, I can't even remember the thickness. It's almost 3/4. It's just a hair under 3/4 inch plywood. So they're super sturdy. Say that 5 times fast. But they're really sturdy, and I don't know. You could use them for tools. You can use them for gardening. Flowers. I made them big enough so they'll fit like mason jars with flowers on the sides here on these ones.
Oh, that would be
ones.
Really cute.
And, or, you know, you can use them for planting and seeds. They'll also fit seed packets really nicely down in there so you can organize them. But lots of fun things you can do with these.
This doesn't have a bird on it, but Zeb will do his little bird logo on the front. So these are just not on there yet because we were like rushing to get these finished. And we do leave the logo of the plywood on, like on the inside, you'll see that.
They've got some printed, almost like
a little bit of industrial vibe going on there.
You can't see it at that angle, but there's like some printing on here.
Les, if you watched earlier, there are birds on all of the cutting boards, the charcuterie boards.
Here, we'll show Les.
So they are there. Les wants to see it. She just came on. So all the boards have the bird logo. The Zeb custom made.
That's
how
you know.
Out of a nail. I'm like, give Zeb a nail and a file and he'll make a bird.
So we do have
If you have little kids, you do have to slice grapes.
We do have a bigger one too.
All right, that's the big one. That one is $49.95 because it's like more than twice the size.
This is the big Mamma Jamba. It is double. It's actually two of the one. That's how I used it to make a pattern.
Yeah, and it's a little less than twice.
So these handles, I kind of cut them out rough just because I thought it gave it kind of a primitive, more rustic, actual workshop kind of vibe. So they're not perfect in there. It's pretty close, but it's nice and comfy for my hand. So that you can just kind of carry them around, and they're sturdy. These things are gonna hold up. You can use them for whatever. They're glued and nailed together and shouldn't come apart unless you like drop them out of the back of a truck.
I love it, shouldn't come apart. They're not gonna come
apart. I disclaimed unless you drop it out of the back of a truck.
Tote and board envy here. So this one is $49.95 and it's 20 by 21 by 5 inches.
Here, I'll go get the other one so you can see the comparison in size.
Yep. And Zeb, it's not just nailed it. There's screws in the bottom of this thing.
The big one got screws because it can hold a lot more weight.
Yeah, he wanted to make sure it would last. And there's wood glue in between all the seams, so it's really, really put together. What kind of wood are the boards? These are just
plywood,
but it's the thicker plywood.
It's almost 3/4.
It's like
30 seconds or something.
We ship
like
to
that.
Texas. We ship all over the United States. And if you're out of the country, you can just go to info@JamieRayVintageHome.com and we'll send it to you. But if you're in the United States, you can just go to JamieRayVintageHome.com and you can order any of the things that we're showing you here. And we ship packages out. In fact, if you hear the tape gun in the background, there's literally somebody shipping almost 24 hours a day. We have people shipping all the time.
So a lot of these items, the wood stuff that we just showed you, that stuff is handmade. We can make more of that stuff. But these items that we've refinished, these are custom items that we've picked and refinished.
One of each.
And once they're gone, they're gone. So.
And Les, the wood on the cutting boards is, we have poplar, and then the other one's Douglas fir, yeah?
Yeah, if you watch that.
So there's poplar, which is the big, fancy, pretty exotic type looking wood, and the rest is Douglas fir. It's actually from the joist of our floor addition. So we had to cut off, and we have all this really great wood that we can't do anything with. And so you know us, we're like, what can we do with it?
I'm like, man, I got all these leftover ends that aren't good for building, but let's make some cutting boards.
Yeah, and the nice thing is that when we sell all that wood, we'll be able to turn that money into purchasing more wood for framing up the walls. So we're super excited about that. All right, next item up is a trio. So it comes in a set of three.
So we have these two candlesticks. You got the medium, large, and then we have the urn. Does it come with the greenery?
It comes with the greenery. And it does not have a lid, so it's an urn for your flowers, not for your grandma.
Flowers, not grandma.
So it's listed as the candlestick and urn trio with greenery, and it's $49.95. These are painted in apothecary and white waxed, and it comes with all three plus the greenery for $49.95. So it rounds out a nice little set there.
Yeah, all of these things you're seeing, we ship nationwide.
Bring on the kids projects. All right, we'll get to some kids projects. Actually, the totes were a kids project. Eliza finished those. And the tote, Redrick's tote was there. What else do we have? Oh, we'll do this one next. That's Eliza did that one.
All right, let me move these out of the way.
They don't like what I paint.
They just wanted to see what Jack and Redrick and Eliza do.
I don't have my fake eyelashes on today, and my hair is a little bit out of control. All right, next, we're going to do the Corbel shelf. This one I painted, but Eliza distressed and white waxed it. It has hanging hardware on the back of it. Let me grab that listing up.
Comes with a little cleat back here for hanging.
Yeah, we actually have quite a few things in that color scheme. It's weathered wood with white wax, which is really pretty, makes it look like stone. And I think we should just show them everything that's in that color scheme together. So that way, if they want to buy all the things that are painted like that, they'll see them.
Janet asked if you clear waxed the candlesticks before you white wax them.
No, I white waxed them and then I buffed it back right away and then I clear wax over the top. That's how I do 99% of my white wax is I put it on, I take it off right away and then I clear wax over the top and then I get a really great look. So this one is $22.95 and it measures, and I even spelled my name wrong in the listing, let me fix that. Because I painted it, Eliza white waxed it. It measures 11 inches by 10 by 5.
This is not stone, it's resin.
Yeah, it's resin, but it's got like this really good texture, and because we did the weathered wood with
it's a good casting.
Yeah, it's awesome. So you can hang that on the shelf, or you could just use it as a shelf, or you could use it, let me see real quick. You could just use it as decor like this.
Read Gavin's post, Jamie. We missed it, it flew by.
He says it's okay, you don't need fake eyes, you look very nice and pretty. Thanks, Gavin.
I appreciate that.
And Mariah Ray is a link goddess. It's true. She's like, what are you guys going to have so I can have all the links ready? And I'm like, Mariah, I don't know.
Like, we're winging it here today.
I live my life free and loose.
You know, we were trying to be organized and plan ahead, and we were going to be at the dock getting the shipment at 9:30 so we could show you all the new stuff that came today, and nothing came.
Nothing came. It's okay. I got junk for days. The paint colors on that piece is weathered wood with white wax. Same with these ducks, which these are not kid painted. They're painted by me, but this is the pair of ducks. And I believe, hold on, let me pull up that set here. I just want to make sure that I got to save that. Hold on. I have to save that because I had to fix my name. I spelled my name wrong. I use voice text when I'm putting all the products in the website. So occasionally things will get misspelled.
How much are the galvanized buckets? We'll get to those in just a minute. Are you talking about these with the flowers?
Oh, I'll have to look those up. Hold on, I can't find the ducks.
Right now we're looking for ducks.
Pair of ducks. All right, so the pair of ducks, they measure 7.5 inches by 6 inches. They come in a set of two, and they're $19.95. And they're cute. These are also the weathered wood with the white wax. And this is the twin caddy if you want to jump ahead and look for this. It's already on the website. We'll get
to it.
Yeah,
we can show them now.
Well, I want to show them all the stuff that's painted in those colors.
Oh, in the weathered wood?
Okay. Ooh, Debbie Beard's in the house.
Hey, Debbie.
She says, hi, Gavin. You still have your phone. Was somebody going to take your phone, Gavin? Nobody told me. All right. Delissa says, apothecary with white wax set of three. I don't know if maybe she bought it or she had a question on it.
I don't know.
Gavin says he's at his mom's until they get here. So he's got his phone for a little bit. And Cobweb says, get our ducks in a row. All right. So
our ducks are in a row. They're literally in a row right now.
They're literally in a row.
I lined them up.
So this is the weathered wood sconce. It's weathered wood and white wax. Again, that really great combo that makes it look like stone. It's cast resin and has hanging hardware in the back. We only have one, and it was painted by, well, the front was painted by me. We gave a quick coat to the back by Eliza, and then Eliza wet distressed and white waxed this sconce. So if you buy the other Corbel shelf and you want them to match, this is the exact same finish as the other Corbel shelf and the ducks. So that'll give you kind of
a... Here, I'll show them all together in case you want to get a bundle deal going.
A bundle deal. It doesn't mean you're going to save any money. Oop. It just means you're going to get a lot of good stuff if you get the bundle deal. Is there another... Eliza, are you done with one of those?
Eliza wants me to show
you
these big things.
Okay, but we don't have
that
listed yet. There was
no price yet.
Something else in this, no?
Not that I see. I mean, maybe down below, but I don't have it yet.
All right, I think that's it. But we have one more item that Eliza just finished. So, Zed, would you bring that over? Actually, Eliza, you want to bring the finished one? And then I will photograph it and get it up on the website. So these are big mama jammas. Eliza just finished painting and white wax. We have two of them. Eliza, bring it over here. Say hi, Eliza.
Oh, hi.
It was her day to come work with us. All right, but are
I'm
going to
move the
picture?
Camera back so they can see how big it is.
Eliza, come over here and be in the picture. I'm going to put it on the website. So these are huge. They are priced at $49.95 each.
We have two.
We have two of them. And Eliza, you stand right there. Let me take your picture. Oh, is that, are you wanting to be in the picture too?
No, I'm good.
All right, hold on. And these are done in weathered wood and white wax. And they aren't even up on the website yet because I just took that picture. Seb, tell them a little bit more about the size. Show them the top. You can put candles or greenery.
So I believe these are for outdoors, for putting little topiary type plants on them or in them. I don't know that you can really plant in them, but they're heavy. They got a really heavy weighted base, and the white wax on them makes them look like they've been out aging and getting oxidized.
Yeah, they were like
a
light blue color before, which we didn't love, so we went with the weathered wood with the white wax. If you guys have not tried this combo, make sure you're hitting up jamierayvintage.com for your paint, because weathered wood and white wax is perfect.
These are resin. We can ship them. They're not,
we have a measuring
they're
tape.
Not concrete.
I'm putting these up on the website right now. Eliza's like, what am I going to do while you guys are live? And I'm like, don't worry, you can do these and then I'll sell them. All right, I'm going to add my product. We're going to call these the Eliza XL candlesticks.
Okay, so these are 9.5 inches in diameter.
9.5 inches in diameter.
By 25.25 tall.
Okay.
And then the top, if you want that, is 5.5 inches. So you can fit a big candlestick up here if you wanted to use these indoors.
Zeb, I was using voice text.
Sorry.
That's all right.
Sorry.
Hold on. Painted and waxed by Eliza, made of resin. All right, got that in there. And what did I say, $49.95?
Each.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's put that picture in there. Get that up. And we have two of those. And we're going to put these in the found category because we only have two. So when they're gone, they're gone. All right, give that a minute and those will be up on the website. So these are done by Eliza and Zeb. These are the ones you painted the other day.
Yep. So Saturday, if you guys watched that donated thrift haul, because our friends have been bringing stuff and just leaving it on the back porch for us.
Junkie friends are the best friends. Also a t-shirt at jamierayvintage.com. Oh, they said bird bath. You could do a bird bath.
Oh, yeah. You could
and then,
totally do that.
Pam says she loves your hair. Eliza braids her own hair because this is all I know how to do.
She wants to be a hairdresser, so that's what she's aspiring to. She watches lots of YouTube videos on how to do crazy hairstyles.
Oh, looks like Gavin is leaving. We'll see you later. So Eliza came to the shop with me today, and Lauren, who ships for me, had matching twinner hair with Eliza. All right, so what did you tell them what color those were painted in?
So these are in skeleton key and white waxed. And
yes.
Then this, they've got like a yellowish color underneath that's peeking through.
That one does, it's and like then this one has a white underneath. They weren't actually a matching set, we just painted them to
this
match.
This has the yellow too.
No, that's like whiter. This is a hand-turned candlestick that somebody made, you can tell by the bottom. And this is just like a heavy...
This is metal.
Heavy metal? Are you sure?
It feels like
a heavy resin.
No, this is metal.
Okay.
It might be cast.
Yeah,
metal and
heavy.
Hollow, but it's not solid.
So this set is $29.95 for the set. Zeb painted them, but Eliza wet distressed and waxed them, and they're skeleton key and white wax, which is a really great color. Let's see what people are buying over here. Okay, apparently Pauline needed a few things because she got a bunch of enamel, some antique jars, and a white post box. And then we got an order from Sarah. Sarah bought the ducks.
Nice.
Let's see what else we got going here. Alicia bought something. Alicia got herself 4 charcuterie boards and a grain sack apron, and she spent over $200, which means she got free shipping.
Free shipping, what?
Except for Alaska and Hawaii. If you're in the contiguous U.S. and you spend $200, you get free shipping. So if you got to buy for your mom, your aunt, your husband's mom, yourself, put it all in one order. You'll save in shipping.
Okay, so these are a set. It's got coffee, tea, sugar and flour.
Yes, and they're, I made them a set. They did not come that way.
They're not originally a set. I'll show you guys up close so you can see the metal pressed.
These were salvaged, so meaning we found them with a pile of stuff and I scrubbed them and disinfected them, but they still have a lot of the age and wear that you would expect to find on something that came on the side of the
road. So these two are Chromex, and this one says tea on it. This one's the coffee.
She needs a percentage of the sales. Don't worry, my kids get a percentage. I actually pretty much
anytime these kids don't work for free, I'll tell you that.
Anytime my kids want something, like from Amazon or whatever, they pretty much get what they ask for because they work really hard. So this set is priced at $24.95. And there are four of them, and they are, like I said, they're a group set that didn't come that way, but I thought they looked really good together. And I know some people wanted them painted and some people didn't, so I kept the price down at $24.95. So if you got them, you could go ahead and paint them, because they've got a lot of like detail that if you wet distressed, you could see the words that came through really good. Those two are on top and these two are on the front.
Yeah.
And that one says sugar on it.
The biggest one is going to measure 6.5 by 7 inches, and the smallest one is 5.5 inches by 4 inches. And Les says she's laughing.
Someone said that this one here, I believe, looks like something that their aunt is in.
Like an urn?
Yeah.
Oh, you put your urn in the tea jar?
Your aunt.
Your aunt? Your urn in the...
No, it's probably an urn, but it probably looks similar to this.
But it doesn't say tea, because I'm just... Jana says she digs these.
These are cool.
We kind of dug them because we literally found them in the dirt. Anyways, $24.95, and you can dig them at your house and paint them or leave them or whatever. I've got a few of those left, but that was the like complete set that had the flour, the sugar, the tea, and the coffee. So.
All right, this one here.
Oh, they want to see the coffee canister up close. Could you do that? Can you do it for getting Jenny with it? Oh, they said the sugar one was the one that looked like her aunt had it in. We can't keep canister sets in stock. Neither can we. They always go really fast. Actually, I had a grease can, and that actually sold by itself for $9 before I even could get it listed. Somebody emailed me. I had like 5 emails, and the first person that emailed me got it. So sometimes when we do our thrift hauls, things go really, really fast. So this next one is fun. It is not old, but it looks old because it's got the aluminum red top, and it was really greasy and dirty when we found it, and I ran it through the shop dishwasher.
It says, hand wash, do not microwave.
That's a lie. I washed it in the dishwasher and it was fine. So don't you believe what it says on the bottom of it. I mean, maybe it should
be. It comes with a little authentic chip over here.
Yeah, I put that in the listing. I always take pictures of any damage. So this is the clear glass with red aluminum lid canister. It's $9.95. And I included a close-up of the little ding and chip in it.
Would be great on the counter with some candies or fun cookies or something. Cookies are always fun.
How do you spell what you're calling those carved out trays? Charcuterie? Lolly put it in there.
It's hard. It's a hard word to say. I don't know. Did you put tags in there?
Les wanted to know if the canisters fit inside of each other. Some of them will and some of them won't because there's one that's like at an angle. Yeah. But I think when I ship them, I should be able to ship some inside of the other ones. Which color milk paint did you put on those boards?
Oh, so that is lantern on those boards.
Oh, lantern, which is black.
So what I do to make my own stain is I use the hemp oil, which is food safe, biocertified from Sweet Pickens, and then I use the milk paint in powder, and I just mix it into the oil like you would water, but I do like a wash almost.
So it's like a tinted hemp oil, essentially. Yeah.
And then I just wipe it on there, and then it's good to go. And food safe.
Hashtag one and done.
All right, let's show them these. These are also, we wanted to have like kind of a, so sometimes I get carried away and make really crazy ornate style corbels. So we wanted just something simple.
Hey, hold those up and smile. That's a better angle. Oh, hold on, you look all crazy. All right, I'll have to fix that one later.
Yeah, we'll get a good picture of them. So
these are pretty cute.
So these are also the poplar wood, but it wasn't the cool grain design that the cutting board was. So we went ahead and painted them. These are painted in black velvet underneath, and then they've got tarnished pearl on the top and just distressed back through. And these are perfect for like shelves and things. They don't have hanging hardware on them because I always make them in anticipation that someone's going to use them on their kitchen island or their bar like we have on ours. So I leave them so that people can do them. If you want to find out how to hang these, just look up Jamie Ray Vintage Corbel, and I have several videos on how I hang them without hardware on.
So are we going to sell them as a set or individually?
I would say individually, because I could make someone 100 or I can make someone 1.
All right, so let's go ahead and add those in here. We're going to call them the Zeb Corbels.
Like if you want to put these all on your front porch, you know, on the side of your posts. I am. Look at that. Sold. And then you can paint them to whatever color you want.
Can you give me measurements on those? Sold individually. Measures.
12.
12 inches.
By 9.
By 9 inches.
By 2 inches.
By 2 inches.
And they're made out of poplar, so they're really nice, tight grain, and they are structural if you need them to be.
All right, and how much am I pricing these babies at?
I don't know. How much are you pricing them at?
Like $19.95 each?
Sure.
Is that okay? How about $18.95?
I like that better, because they are fairly simple, and they're hand cut out. They're not cut out on the CNC, so there will be some slight variations and imperfections and things, because, you know, between Harrington and I, we try to cut straight lines, but every now and then you get a little wiggle in the saw, and you got to sand that out.
All right, you're going to find these in the Handmade and the Home Decor collection.
Handmade and Home Decor, and what do we call them?
I'm adding them right now, $18.95 each. All right.
But they're just nice, simple design, and they're 2 inches thick. They're really nice and thick.
All right. Oh, it's charcuterie, not chartreuterie. Mm. You guys know that I never say anything the way that I'm supposed to say it. It doesn't.
Five-hole cheese mold. Was this on the website already?
Nope. I just put it up today. We only have two. I could probably get more, but as of right now, we only have two. These are the five-hole cheese molds. Let me pull that one up here.
So these are shallower than the sugar mold, and the hole is much wider around. I think we showed these a couple weeks ago.
We have the three-hole and the single hole, but now we have the five-hole. So if you want more holes than everybody else, now we got the five-hole. All right, hold on. Let me see the recently updated products.
Vintage Sin says it's her first time. Your first time catching us live on the Stay at Home Shopping Network. It's fun. We enjoy doing it.
It's been. Oh, I actually put this as the cheese mild. We're gonna make that a cheese mold. Save
Let's
that.
Make it a cheese mold.
It measures 26x5x2, and it's priced at $39.95. And we have two on the website.
We'll get more of these, but right now they have limited stock, so we have limited stock.
Lolly says she has a weakness for molds.
Hey,
you know what? I have a weakness for many things. That is why I have a store, so I can buy all the
things. Jamie had them called cheese milds, but you know, you could put some mild cheese in
there. You could put some mild salsa. I mean, I don't know that I put salsa in it. You put a bowl and then put the bowl in there of salsa. I updated it though, and now says cheese mold, not cheese mild.
So this is the new version of Tarnished Pearl.
Oh, are they asking what that is?
Someone said it, Lisa. So there's an old kind of creamy, yellowish, creamy color of Tarnished Pearl, and this is the new version, which is like a gray, white tone.
Yeah, it just came out like maybe a month ago, so if you have the old one, if you didn't buy it from us, if you bought it from another retailer, you need to ask them, is it old or new? For us, you always know because on our website, it says new Tarnished Pearl has the new color. We do reserve some of the old Tarnished Pearl in case somebody needs to finish a project. But if you bought it from somebody besides us, then you need to ask them if it's old or new. But on our website, since the new one came out, we've only had the new color, and it says new Tarnished Pearl, so people know what they're getting. All right, so this is a funny story. I ordered four enamel. I only got three, and this one's not enamel. It's aluminum, and the brand is AluFix, and it's a water jug. We have one of them. And the enamel pitchers sold really quickly. I don't know if these are as popular, but Deb says he really likes it.
I like the aluminum one a lot. It's got more of an industrial feel than the enamel ones did.
I think it would also keep your water really cold.
Yeah, it's almost like those... newfangled mugs that keep your water...
The newfangled mugs? The thermoflask?
Yeah, almost like a thermoflask.
So this is $49.95, and it measures 10 inches across by 15 inches tall. Is it more than 10?
Yeah.
Well, if you include the handle.
It's 10 and a half if you include the handle.
So when I show a picture with multiple items, if you get all the items, it's going to say set. And if you get the flowers or the greenery with it, it'll say with greenery or with flowers. So that'll kind of help you figure that out. But yeah, if there's a picture and it's got three items, look to see if it says set. And in the description, it'll say set of two, set of three. So that way you know exactly what you're getting. Jana says she's not sure about that jug. Zeb's actually not sad because I think if nobody buys it, he's going to fill it with ice water and just take it to the farmhouse this summer.
It's a true story.
All right. Can you use it? Yeah, I feel like absolutely.
Yeah, it smells like dish soap inside.
Well, it's because I washed it.
Probably just needs rinsed. It's aluminum.
It smells like dish soap because I just washed it.
There you go.
All right, so this is a found item that I added an IOD transfer to the bottom, and then I did seal it, so you can wipe it down if you need to. Why is Harrington calling me? Harrington, I'm live on YouTube.
Oh.
Did you need something, or can I call you
back? Why did you answer is the question.
What, sweetie?
Like right now?
Like right now, you're live on. Thanks for calling in. How can I help you?
Hang up on him now.
I just needed to talk to Dad, but...
Oh, well, he's right here.
There we go. Problem solved.
Sorry if you're watching, Harrington. We'll call you back.
He wasn't watching. He would have known not to call.
I'm that mom. I always want to know if my kids need something. Zeb, on the other hand, I'm like, whatever.
I will get to you, Nat, tomorrow sometime, maybe.
So this is the Rooster Canister. It's $14.95. It is a found item. We only have one of them, and it has the IOD transfers. So if you guys do use IOD transfers, this one on the bottom, I sealed it with liquid patina, and it has actually, I did it a couple months ago, and it stayed really, really well.
Yep.
Will mason jars fit in the cheese mold? Yes. You want to go grab a blue mason jar?
I will. I'll run grab one real quick. Show them the
Okay, we'll go with this one. So this doesn't come with the flowers. We actually sell all of these peonies. Can be bought individually on the website. We have blush, pink, and white. And they're in the floral section. And I believe they're like two something each. $2.65. I can't remember exactly. And this is the twin caddy. So somebody was asking about that earlier. This is something that we actually buy wholesale. We added like 11 new items in home decor this last week, and I don't have all of them here, but this is one that we just added. So make sure you guys are hitting up the home decor section of the website, because there's a lot of fun new stuff that I put on there. But let me pull this one up. Sorry, it's gonna take me just a second. We've sold a few of them already. The tall twin caddy, it is $13.95, and it's actually decently, it's 10 inches by 5 inches by 10 inches, and the handle is wood, and it's got a fun galvanized look. So there you go, $13.95. And you can spend roughly $42 on flowers. Oops.
I found mostly quartz.
And we're back. So you can actually purchase these. I don't have all of these listed, but I believe there might be one or two of these ball jars left on the website, because I know we just sold one. So you can pick them up. They say you're funny for hanging up on your son. So yeah, you can fit.
So these are quartz, and they fit in there. The pint would probably fit even better.
Oh, that's cute.
Because some of these are a little wider because they're old and they're not uniform size.
Can you leave those in there? When we're done, I'll re-photograph that. That's cute. I never even thought about that.
There you go.
There you go.
This one's kind of square, so it's not fitting as well as the round ones.
Okay, so Carla says, if you use Constant Comment tea inside the aluminum pitcher, it'll take the metallic taste out. Just brew some tea, let it sit in the pitcher for a while, then rinse. That is a really great tip, because we don't drink tea, so I would have never, well, I drink chamomile, but I would have never thought to brew tea, so.
You know, I wonder.
You rock, Carla. All right. Les said she'd make iced tea in that pitcher. All right, school is about to start in Australia, so Rose has to go play teacher. I'm assuming she's teaching a school. Oh, that's cute.
So these ones that are slightly larger don't.
The bigger ones don't fit, but
the big old antique ones don't fit super great, but the small ones fit.
Well, these are antique, just the ones with these lids on them like that, but these ones fit better.
So there's the tote.
Oh, Mariah says the canning jars are sold out on the website.
Oh.
So you're gonna have to get your own. Actually, we do also have a new caddy that just came up that comes with three canning jars. They're not actually old, but they look old. Let me see if I can find that one. That one's really fun. Hold on. And they come with metal lids, which I also thought was fun. Let's see. I have to scroll back because there's so much new stuff that came. I'm getting there slowly but surely.
The jar
organizer with jars. It's $24.95 and it's metal. I don't have it here to show you, but it comes with three canning jars in that. But it looks like the blue ones are all filled out. I'll try to get some more on tomorrow. Let's talk about the artichoke in the room.
We got this artichoke here and Jamie painted it. This is probably cast plaster or terracotta. Probably terracotta.
It's plaster.
Plaster? Okay. I can't tell. It's been painted.
It's plaster.
Oh, no, it's clay.
Oh, it's clay. I know it's itches. And we did the patina finish on this giant, it's listed as the giant Purina. It's actually giant patina. This is why it's good that I go back through these. It's $29.95, and show them against your forearm. It's actually rather large.
Big.
20 inches by 7 inches across, and it's painted with a new DIY copper pennies, with the Shipwrecked, and originally it was white underneath, so it's got a really great finish on that. Lolly says Mariah is hot.
She got the link so fast, she got it up there before you...
She got the copper Purina.
Before you edited it.
Mariah is like super good at making things, or sure things are spelled correctly, so it's probably driving her crazy.
Is this tote on there, or is this just on
no,
the table?
No, that tote is totally on there. So I did that tote a while back. It's listed as the Marmalade tote. I can't remember the price, but the tag is on there if you want to look.
Price is $9.95, crockery okay. Mini tote, because it's got a crockery stamp on there. But Jamie says she's named it something different on the website.
Oh, why did that? No, it's the Marmalade tote, but for one whatever reason, only the close-up picture showed and not the actual like item itself. So I'm going to fix that real quick. I put roughly like 50 items on in a very limited amount of time.
So if you just joined, we're doing the stay-at-home shopping network. Most of these items that we've shown today are one-of-a-kind unique items that once they're gone, they'll be gone. And we'll have new stuff next week because we've just been going through all of our stuff and refinishing it.
All right, I fixed the Marmalade tote picture. If you look it up before it's done uploading, you're not going to see a picture on there. But this one is painted. The outside's white swan, and the inside is like a buttercream, and then it's got a, like a salmon-colored turned handle, and it's solid wood. And we only have one of those. Liza. Let's see. Mariah already got the tag on there. Now, it used to have a very interesting dated paint finish. I can't remember what was under here. I'd have to watch the video.
It was like a bunny or something.
It's very 1980s. All right, so these are fun. These are something that you guys have been asking for a long time, and I finally got around to individually photographing them.
All right, once we're done with these, I think that's it for today.
No,
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Is there more things?
I feel like there are more things. But okay. Oh, yeah. I have some books, and I have some shoe stretchers to show them. So we'll show them those. But these are the Idaho Utah grain sacks. So we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Actual antiques. They have been used and there will be repairs and stains. And
that's
someone
upside down
sharpie...
and that's letter A.
Oh, whoops. And someone may have Sharpie markered on some of them.
Yeah, but not me. Because they're actual old
probably
ones.
From the factory. There we go. Now that makes
no,
sense.
No, not grain sacks. Lolly, do you not like grain sacks? Or do you really like grain sacks and you're worried you're going to buy too many? So these
this
are...
This is number A.
Listed
or letter A, letter A.
These are $28.95 each. And they're all unique. So if you like one, you got to grab it. Because I have listed them individually. They have different dates, different towns, different brands on them. This is B. Jeff says, please don't drink out of the aluminum jug. Nine Lives, we could ship the twin caddy to Australia, but you're going to need to email info@jamierayvintagehome.com, I can get you pricing. So later today, I'll check that email.
So this is what I'm talking about. Someone wrote down there on the bottom with a marker at some point, probably while it was still in use.
Yeah, maybe a zip code or something. Carolyn says she agrees. Maybe you're not supposed to drink out of aluminum. Is it dangerous?
I don't think so.
My mom grew up drinking out of those aluminum cups, but maybe you're not supposed to.
I don't know. A lot of stuff's made out of aluminum. The tin foil's made out of aluminum.
I don't drink off a tin foil.
But I sure do wrap my
You should probably Google it before you drink out of anything. There's my disclaimer.
There you go.
Alright. Letter C. Price of grain sacks, these are $28.95 each.
And comes with the authentic stains.
They have been washed, but you probably could soak them in. Oh, it causes Alzheimer's. Okay, don't drink out of the aluminum.
There you go.
Unless you're already 95, because it'll take a while to kick in. All right, so this one is, which letter is this one? So what does it say?
D.
D. Can you see D on there?
So I think we have.
And I have individual pictures on the website of all of them.
I think we had some that were already like this, but this one's got like purple stamping on it.
Yeah, on the back. Oh, I didn't show them that. There's purple stamping on that. So the thing about you shouldn't drink hot liquids out of aluminum, cold doesn't matter. Oh, okay. All right, so this is the Idaho sugar bag, and this one is 1942. The dates are important because a lot of times people want them like the date that they were born or their parents or their grandma was born. So if you look on the website, they're all listed. So is that one B? Yeah. I do big, long pillows out of them, which is fun. like the big lumbar pillows. We had one on the website.
These are actually really heavy duty and in better shape than a lot of them that we get.
Oh yeah, they don't have any holes. They do have some repairs. Also, this is what we make our aprons out of. I think we have one grain sack apron and one grain sack pillow left on the website.
Oh, you fibbed. This one has a hole.
It's been fixed, hasn't it?
Kinda.
Well, if they have any damage, you'll see them in the pictures because I listed each one separately. So that's the last one there. How did I wash the grain sacks? So these come from my picker and she washes them in her washing machine and then she line dries them.
This is a 1935 one.
When I wash them at home, I wash them and dry them. I have big industrial washers and dryers because we have five kids and I've never had a problem with them. But these come pre-washed by my picker. All right, I think that's it, but I wanted to show them a few more of the new things. Oh, I'll go get the books. You talk to them for a second.
All right.
Dance or something.
I'm going to look at comments.
All right.
They're still talking about what you should drink from, aluminum or whatever. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what the deal is with the aluminum. You know, do your homework, folks. Check it out on the Google and see what everybody's saying. Yeah, they're sugar sacks. So those grain sacks that we have, Jamie's been hoarding them. She was going to do a bunch of projects with them. But then the gal that was sewing all of our pillows for us is no longer doing that. She got busy doing some other projects and couldn't keep up. So we might have Jamie's friend Christy do it. She's working for us now. So we will see. We will see if we have more pillows.
She's literally working right now. I'm going to go there. Oh, this is also new.
Do you have these? I don't know how much these are.
Yeah, they're on the website. I just put them up.
All right, well, we're at an hour. Let's wrap this thing up.
Oh, we got to wrap it up? Okay, so make sure you guys are checking out all the new home decor items.
Well, let's
show
them. We'll tell them what these are.
I know. I'm just saying we don't have time to show them all the new things. So just know that there's more. So these are priced at $19.95 for the set. And these are floor shine shoe stretchers. We also have this three-tiered tray. It's wire, metal, and I think I have... Hold on, let's see. Where? Hold on, I got to keep going. Well, if I keep going,
And then the books, right?
And then the books, but where is this one? I don't know. It's $19.95. It's on the website. And the set of three books, $22.95. And then, oh, I forgot one thing. Don't go.
Don't go. She forgot one thing. But do go to jamierayvintagehome.com to find all this stuff we've been showing you.
Oh, okay. Well, I lied. I have two.
So this is The Trumpet and the Swan by E.B. White.
And it comes in a set. You get all three books.
This one is Churchill, taken from the diaries of Lord Moran. And then this one is Hotel by Arthur Haley. And it's got this fun color, the yellow pages, and then that's what the binding looks like there on the back.
All right. So these are grain sorters. We have a ton of them, and they're all unique. So they're just listed individually. And these are up on the website, so make sure you guys are checking out the grain sorters. And then we also have, I don't know if you guys can tell how cool these are on the website, light brown and dark brown. They're actual, I think, wood. Yeah, they are vintage Japanese lamp bases. So they came from Japan and they had a lamp, which is why there's a hole in the middle. And I just think you can make a lot of really fun projects with them. So Mariah just linked the grain sorter and she'll link these as well. So these are the Japanese lamp bases. They're cool.
Will they fit a jar?
Will they fit a canning jar? I think that they would. And if you guys saw the two nightstands that I just listed, if you haven't checked that out, we have a furniture section on our website. Some of them include shipping, some of them don't, so read the description. But these are staged on there.
They'll probably fit a pint. This one here will. These bigger ones will fit a jar, no problem.
That's really cute. I like that. I never thought about layering
them. I'm all about the jars.
What do you do with a grain sorter? So just use, these are used kind of like a candlestick decor, so you could totally put a candlestick in them. Or they all have holes in them, kind of like a flower frog, so you can also put flowers in them. Jamie, I love your selling mode hairstyle. This hair is called I Didn't Do It Today.
All right, I think that's it.
That is. Make sure you guys are hitting up jamierayvintage.com, and we will be live for our fourth episode. I can't believe it. It'll be 4 weeks, next week.
Since next
we start
week.
Doing this.
This is episode
of the
3.
The Stay at Home Shopping Network next Thursday, 4 p.m. Mountain Time. Make sure you hit subscribe and give us a thumbs up. and hit up jamierayvintagehome.com for all the home decor. And if you want to paint like us, you can pick up the paint at jamierayvintage.com. And we'll have an edited video up tomorrow.
Don't forget to share the video if you're still watching.
Oh yeah, please share it, because YouTube's getting weird. So hit share and put it in Facebook, because YouTube takes forever to upload our videos now. So that would be awesome.
All right, guys. Thank you. We appreciate
it. Love you guys. Stay safe. Don't lick anybody. And thanks for joining us for the Stay at Home Shopping Network. Bye-bye. I got paint on my hand.